Hello friends, this is Mr. P.S. Bidkar from Sanjay Godad Institute, Satyagraha, going to explain about the chopper. In that, we are going to discuss the step-down chopper. Chopper is a static device which converts fixed DC into variable DC, so output is variable DC. So it is also known as DC to DC converter. So it is widely used for motor control applications in case of DC motor. It is also used for regenerative braking. The switches used are thyristors, as well as we can go for using MOSFETs, IGBTs for fast switching. It is having faster response, lower maintenance, small size and smooth control. Choppers are of two types. First is step down chopper, in which we are going to have low output voltage compared to input voltage. Second is step up chopper. In case of step up chopper, we are getting more output than that of input voltage. Principle of step down chopper. This is the circuit diagram for step down chopper. Instead of using thyristor or SCR, we can also go for MOSFET as well as IGBT as a switching device. MOSFETs are having good response for high frequency. IGBTs are used up to 1 kHz. MOSFETs are used up to 10 kHz. So when we apply, in case of step down chopper, when we apply gate pulse, thyristor will turn on. When thyristor is turned on, supply voltage appears across the load. When thyristor is off, supply voltage will not appear across the load. Output voltage is zero. So these are the waveforms for step down chopper. In this case, we can see the T on and T off. So this is T on and T off. They will have time equal to T. Another thing, the output voltage is V. So these are the waveforms for output voltage. The same can be observed for the current also. Output current is given by V by R. So VDC is average value of output or load voltage. IDC is average value of output current or load current. T on is on time of a switch. T off is off time of a switch. Total time T is given by T on plus T off. So it is called as period of switching. In other words, frequency of chopping F is called as, or F is given by 1 upon T. So it is called as frequency of switching or chopping frequency. Then we can obtain the formula for average output voltage for a chopper. It is given by VDC. So VDC is equal to V supplied voltage into T on upon T on plus T. So in other words, T on plus T is given by T. So T on plus T is nothing but duty cycle. It is generated by D. So final output VDC is given by V into D, or in other words, supplied voltage into duty cycle. Now we'll go for average output current. So average output current is given by VDC upon R. So VDC is given by V into T on upon T. So in other words, V upon R into D. D is duty cycle. Now we can go for calculating the RMS value of output voltage. So V RMS or V output is given by square root of 1 upon T integration from 0 to T on into V output square into DT. But in case of T on, V output is nothing but V. So the formula is written like this. V output is equal to square root of 1 upon T integration from 0 to T on V square into DT. So is equal to V square upon T into T on. In other words, it is written as square root of T on upon T into V. So in other words, we can write V RMS is equal to square root of D into V. So D is nothing but duty cycle and V is supplied voltage. Output power. Output power is given by output voltage into output current. So output current is nothing but I output is equal to V output upon R. Or in other words, output power is given by V output square upon R. So V output square is nothing but D into V square. So final output power is given by duty cycle into supplied voltage square upon load resistance. Now effective input resistance of a chopper. So it is given by or denoted by Ri is equal to V upon IDC. So Ri is equal to R upon D. The output voltage can be varied by varying the duty cycle. So this is the end of step down chopper.